National award-winning actors Kangana Ranaut and Rajkumar Rao are a diabolical pair in Judgemental Hai Kya, directed by Prakash Kovalamudi. This is Manjusha Radhakrishnan from Gulf News Tabloid, and I've just been to watch Judgemental Hai Kya. Bobby is someone who's quirky and is living with a mental health disorder where she hears multiple voices in her head. It's not an easy disease to live with, but Kangana Ranaut makes it very, very convincing. She's so much fun as this odd, quirky, eccentric landlady Bobby Agarwal. She's a treat to watch. In fact, raise your hand if you have ever wondered if Kangana Ranaut has lost the plot or not. I mean, she's one of these belligerent divas in Bollywood today who headbutts the media, has an opinion about everything, and is brazenly outspoken. So there are many times where you wonder whether she's gone overboard or not. This movie doesn't provide you with all the answers, but it introduces you to a very lovable character called Bobby, who's wonderfully unhinged. And then there's Rajkumar Rao, another award-winning actor. To see both Kangana Ranaut and Rajkumar Rao reunite on the big screen with Judgemental Hai Kya is a reason enough to go watch this film. They are a diabolical pair, as I said, and it's almost like they're competing to win the crown for who's more cuckoo than the other. Judgemental Hai Kya is a compelling psychological thriller laced with wit and some smart writing by Kanika Dhillon. One of the best parts about this movie is that it's powered by some very good performances by its lead players and its supporting cast. There is Hussein Bilal, who is amazing. You can see Bilal's impressive command over his comic timing at a scene set in a supermarket. There's Bobby, who's slightly unhinged, she's in a bad mood. She's asking her dispensable date, played by Hussein Bilal, that why can't he be more like the vegetable potato? Because according to her, potatoes are very amiable, they go with everything, and they're an easy vegetable to mix with any dish. What she doesn't realize is that she's prickly as a cactus and is not so amiable, but demanding that out of her partner and a very dispensable date that she uses is hilarious. The witty scenes between Kangana Ranaut's character and Bilal's character are hilarious to watch. This is one of the best examples of a well-cast film where the lead players are diabolical. They are so good at what they do, but even the supporting cast is equally good. Even Jimmy Shergill, who's in a very half-baked part as this drama coach in London, is quite impressive. Even with very little, he does his bit to add some life and verve into his character. Before the promotions of this film, all the attention went to Kangana Ranaut because she had a spat with the Indian media, an Indian journalist, and there's a lockdown and boycott of this actress. But the actual hero of this film seems to be Rajkumar Rao, who is waiting in the shadows to shine. Rajkumar Rao in a scene threatens Kangana Ranaut not to push his buttons, because Kangana Ranaut is this cranky and eccentric landlady who likes to pry into his life along with his new wife, played by Amaira Dastur. He tells her that don't push his buttons, he can be more psycho than her. So it's a very interesting scene and a very telling scene where you are not sure whether he's actually joking or whether he means business. This is one of the powers of Rajkumar Rao. He keeps you second guessing throughout the film. The mystery that unravels at the end is very predictable. You may have smelt it a mile away, but don't give up on these war players. Another thing that goes for this film is a snappy length. It's around 150 minutes long, and it's just the right length where the thriller does not seem overstretched or does not seem too bloated. While the collective acting is splendid, one of the things that let me down is the references to the Indian mythological text Ramayana. There's a twist where the actress Kangana Ranaut thinks she is the avenging heroine Sita in Ramayana. Those scenes seem very contrived and forced, and I did not particularly take to it. However, it's a small blip in an otherwise enjoyable film. I've gone with 3.5 out of 5. For a full review, go to gulfnews.com/tabloid.